Pollution is when harmful substances contaminate the air, water, or the earth. Air pollution is the introduction of chemicals and particulates into the Earth's atmosphere. Particulates are the microscopic solid or liquid matter floating in the air, including dust, smoke, pollen, spores, bacteria, and viruses. Common gases that pollute the atmosphere include chlorofluorocarbons, sulfur dioxide, carbon monoxide, and nitrogen oxides. These gases are produced by industry and motor vehicles and then released into the atmosphere. Motor vehicles are a major source of air pollution. As people become more affluent in populated developing countries, more motor vehicles are added to the roads, contributing even more pollution. In urban areas, this manifests itself as smog, a haze that cloaks the lower atmosphere, resulting in poor visibility. The word smog is a combination of the words smoke and fog. Prolonged periods of calm atmospheric conditions prevent the dispersion of emitted gases and particulates. This can result in the accumulation of large atmospheric concentrations of sulfur dioxide and particulates, sometimes accompanied by a natural fog. This problem is worse in cities that lie in a basin surrounded by high mountains. In many cities, smog is significantly worse in winter due to the use of coal for electricity generation, when power use increases to heat homes due to cold temperatures. Chemical plants, petrochemical plants, oil refineries, PVC factories, incinerators, large livestock farms, plastic factories, and other heavy industries also release atmospheric pollution. Agricultural practices also contribute to air pollution. For instance, the clearing of land and the burning of vegetation to make way for pasture results in carbon entering the atmosphere. Chemicals can also enter the atmosphere from the spraying of herbicides and pesticides. So why do something about air pollution? Well, besides the look of an ugly, polluted sky, poor air quality can lead to a range of health problems for both humans and many organisms. For example, in many smoggy cities, there has been an increase in respiratory diseases such as asthma and bronchitis. In some cities, authorities put out daily health warnings about smog levels. Any particles smaller than 10 micrometers in diameter are considered dangerous to human health because they can pass through the throat and nose and into the lungs, causing serious health effects. Particulates less than 2.5 micrometers are referred to as fine particulates and are believed to pose the largest health risks. Smog can cause environmental problems such as reducing the amount of sunlight received by plants to carry out photosynthesis. This leads to the production of tropospheric ozone, which damages plants. Most scientists believe the trend of global warming since the Industrial Revolution has been caused by the emission of greenhouse gases, such as carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, and ozone. There are dire predictions that this could lead to average global temperature increases of up to 2 degrees Celsius, leading to rising sea levels from the melting of polar ice caps and glaciers, as well as an increase in the frequency of violent weather events, tropical diseases, and species extinctions. Another environmental problem caused by air pollution is acid rain. Acid rain is caused by emissions of sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide, which react with water molecules in the atmosphere to produce acids. In nature, most sulfur dioxide in the atmosphere comes from volcanic activity. Man-made sources of these gases are principally from fossil fuel combustion. In the environment, acid rain can have consequences such as the acidification of lakes and streams, damage to trees at high altitudes, and the lowering of the pH value of soil. Acid rain also impacts man-made structures as it speeds up the decay of paint and building materials. Water pollution has many sources. In some places, rivers and the sea are intentionally used for the discharge of untreated sewage and industrial waste. Surface runoff and stormwater drains in urban areas carry chemical contaminants into rivers. In rural areas, runoff containing chemical fertilizers, pesticides, and farm animal feces make their way into rivers and streams. This can result in eutrophication, which is the process by which a high concentration of nutrients, particularly phosphates and nitrates, make their way into a water body. This results in algal blooms, such as seen here in this lake. When algae dies, they consume the oxygen in the body of water, thereby creating the state of hypoxia, which in turn causes the death of other organisms such as fish. Accidental oil spills such as the Rena oil spill off the east coast of New Zealand's North Island in 2011 have huge environmental impacts, causing the deaths of large numbers of marine creatures and seabirds. Oil spills are difficult to clean up, and the costs of doing so are enormous. When people are exposed to oil spills, it can cause skin irritations and rashes. Natural disasters also cause considerable water pollution. For example, floods and storm surges from hurricanes often result in water being contaminated by the mixing of floodwaters with sewage. In 2011, the Fukushima 1 nuclear power plant was hit by a 9.0 magnitude earthquake-triggered tsunami that resulted in the meltdown of three of its nuclear reactors. One of the consequences of this disaster has been the leaking of highly radioactive water into the Pacific Ocean. Water pollution greatly harms the wildlife of oceans and rivers, as well as causing problems for people who depend on it. This is especially so in developing countries, where millions of people lack access to safe drinking water due to the contamination by untreated sewage and other pollutants. A familiar type of pollution on both land and in water bodies is litter. This is when people don't put their unwanted man-made objects away instead of putting them in the appropriate place. Litter is not just untidy, it can become a major threat to wildlife in both rural and marine environments. For example, the impact of discarded plastic bags, which kill tens of thousands of whales, birds, seals and turtles every year, as they often mistake plastic bags for food such as jellyfish. For example, this monkey can be seen eating a nappy that is washed ashore. Soil contamination takes place when chemicals are released into the environment by spills and other means, making the soils infertile and unsuitable for plant life. Toxic chemicals can work its way into the food chain when animals eat the plants. One source of contaminants are heavy metals such as lead. Lead has been used widely since ancient times for making metal products, cables and pipelines, and also in paints and pesticides. Lead is one of four metals that have the most damaging effects on human health. Some of the ways lead can get into the environment include people incorrectly disposing of lead-based paint, the corrosion of lead-based pipes, and the combustion of lead-based gasoline. Lead can accumulate in both soils and water bodies. Soils near highways and farmland tend to have higher concentrations of lead. Organisms that live in the soil also get lead poisoning, and this can work its way through the food chain. Since the 1970s, some countries have responded by phasing out lead-based petrol and paints. Other common soil contaminants include chlorinated hydrocarbons, such as the pesticide DDT, chromium and cadmium, which are found in rechargeable batteries, zinc, arsenic, mercury, and benzene. Landfills are a source of many chemical substances entering the soil and groundwater. This is because of the variety of substances that can be found there, often illegally discarded, or in jurisdictions where there are limited controls. Other annoying forms of pollution include noise pollution, visual pollution, and light pollution. Big cities are blighted by noise, 90% of which comes from motor vehicles. Aircraft, construction, and the sounds of industry are amongst other sources of this nuisance. Not only does noise pollution cause urban dwellers sleepless nights, it can also lead to stress, high blood pressure, and even hearing loss. Visual pollution includes the presence of overhead power lines and even wind farms. Light pollution refers to excessive artificial light that is common in big cities. For example, the abundance of city lights interferes with the ability to see the stars.